Hey, what's going on guys? Floris here and welcome back to another Crypt of the Necrodancer boss fight video. In this episode, we're taking a look at the Necrodancer 1 boss fight. The Necrodancer 1 is a story-related boss in Crypt of the Necrodancer. Players can only encounter this boss when playing as Cadence, and the boss will appear straight after the Deathbringer boss fight. Unlike any other boss fights we've seen so far, this boss fight is not played with one, but with two characters. The player is in control of both Cadence and Dorian. This makes the fight a little bit harder as you will have to focus on two characters at the same time, and also ensure that both of these characters make it alive to the end. If one of the characters dies, it is game over. The first thing that you'll notice once you enter the room is the large stage in the middle. There are several enemies standing on the stage, alongside with the boss himself and the golden loot. Unfortunately, we cannot simply step on the stage and attack the boss. In order to attack the boss, we have to destroy the stage first. Players can destroy the stage by pressing on the buttons. There's always two buttons somewhere on the floor, and the player has to step on both of the buttons at the same time. At this point, it becomes more of a puzzle, as you need to guide Cadence to one button and Dorian to the other button. This is easier said than done though, because both of the characters move simultaneously. Because of this, you will have to make use of the environment. You can use the middle block, you can use the stage itself or the outer walls to block one of the characters while moving the other character. This way you can create some kind of pattern that will match the pattern of the buttons on the floor. Once both of the buttons are being pressed at the same time, a bomb will detonate on the stage. Make sure that you don't stand too close to the stage, as it's possible to get hit by this bomb. Once the bomb has been detonated, a small part of the stage has been destroyed. At this point, two new buttons will spawn. Basically from here on, you want to keep on pressing the buttons while defending yourself from any incoming enemies. It should be noted that the more buttons you press, the stronger the enemies become. After pressing all of the buttons, the stage will be destroyed. At this point, players are able to attack the boss, but it should be noted that the boss will only take damage from the golden loot. Using any other weapon has no effect on the boss. The player has to use the golden loot in order to defeat the boss. As for the boss himself, he has a total of 3 different moves. The first move is his summoning move. Whenever the boss is standing still and points one finger in the air, he will summon a mini boss. His second move is his detonate move. Whenever the boss is standing still and holds purple looking flames into his hand, he is about to explode. This will damage anyone in close proximity. His final move is his freeze move. Whenever the boss is standing still and his hands are glowing purple, he is about to cast a freeze spell. And this will freeze anyone in close proximity. As for the remaining part of the boss fight, it's simply a matter of attacking the boss and dodging his attacks. Once the health of the boss has been depleted, you've won the fight. When it comes down to the Necrodancer 1 boss fight, there's going to be 2 strategies that you can use. The first one is the spawn limit strategy, and the second one is the quick kill strategy. Both strategies are very effective against this boss, and it's recommended that you use those strategies as often as possible, as it really makes this boss fight a lot easier. So yeah, let's take a look at both of these strategies. The first strategy that we're going to take a look at is the spawn limit strategy. If you've been following the guide videos along, you might already be familiar with this strategy, as we've been using this strategy in one of the previous boss fights. Basically, by using the spawn limit strategy, we can prevent the boss from spawning in any more enemies during the fight. This is because the maximum amount of enemies in the room has been reached. This is nowhere near as dangerous as it might sound. In fact, it's a relatively easy and safe strategy to execute. For this strategy, we're going to need the yellow and black skeletons. These type of enemies will only spawn later on the fight, therefore we have to make some progress first. Once you enter the room, make sure that you press the buttons twice. After pressing the buttons twice, stronger enemies will start to spawn in. Yellow type of enemies to be exact. At this point, what you want to do is to focus on the yellow skeletons. Whenever a yellow skeleton spawns in, simply hit him and his head will be chopped off. At this point, what you want to do is to leave the skeleton alone, just don't bother with it. And just focus on the new incoming enemies. Whenever another type of enemy spawns in, for example a yellow skeleton mage or a bat, make sure to eliminate it. As for the skeletons, keep chopping off their head and let them run away. Keep on repeating these steps over and over again until the boss cannot spawn in any more enemies. At this point, the maximum number of enemies in the room has been reached, which should be a total of 5 enemies, excluding the enemies that are on the stage. For the remaining part of the fight, you want to ignore the skeletons on the side. Since their heads are chopped off, they won't possess any threats whatsoever. That being said, we're not there yet. Once the player presses the next buttons, the stage beneath the mummy's children will be destroyed. At this point we've got 3 extra enemies incoming. What we want to do from here on is to take out these 3 enemies first, but it also means that there's going to be 3 more spots in the room. Once you take out these 3 small enemies, the Necrodancer will spawn in new enemies. This time around he spawns in the black type of enemies. At this point do the exact same thing as the previous time. Focus on the skeletons and chop their head off. As for the other type of enemies, make sure to eliminate them. Eventually, you have reached the maximum number of enemies in the room once again. At this point, all enemies in the room, excluding the ones that are on the stage, should be headless skeletons running away. From here on, it's safe to press the final buttons. Once the final buttons have been pressed, the final phase of the fight will start. During this time, the Necrodancer will try to spawn in mini bosses, but he's not able to do that because the maximum amount of enemies in the room has been reached. From here on you can simply take out the boss without having to worry about any other enemies. Finally, it is important to mention that you want to fight off the boss in the middle of the room. This is because more than often the Necrodancer will use his detonate move. Whenever the boss is standing close to the edge of the room and thus being close to one or more of the skeletons, he is capable of killing them by his explosion. When this happens, there's more spots available in the room and there's a high chance that the boss will spawn in a mini boss straight away. That's definitely something you want to avoid at all costs, therefore you want to make sure that you fight the boss in the middle of the room. Moving on to the second strategy, is the quick kill strategy. This strategy can only be executed by using a minimum of 3 bombs, and what it does is that it allows you to skip through the entire first phase of the fight. The strategy itself is very simple. In order to destroy the stage, players don't necessarily have to press the buttons. They can take matters in their own hands by bombing the stage themselves. Simply walk up to the stage and place a bomb. From here on you will destroy a part of the stage. If you end up destroying the stage beneath one or more enemies, they won't get killed in the process. Instead, they will drop down on the ground and from there on try to attack the player. Make sure that you eliminate the enemies that come off the stage. And from here on it's simply a matter of repeating the steps. Keep placing a bomb in front of the stage to destroy it. Once the player blows up the stage beneath the boss, the final phase will start. The quick kill strategy is quite a risky strategy, as this time around you will be flying through the first phase. As a result, the Necrodancer will spawn in quite a few enemies during his final phase, including mini bosses. Therefore the strategy isn't much recommended if you're trying to get through this fight the safest way. In that case, it is better to use the spawn limit strategy that has been explained previously on. Personally, the only time I would recommend to use this strategy is during speedruns. For instance, when you're trying to obtain the Speed Demon achievement, which requires you to clear a Cadence All Zones mode under 15 minutes. That is where this quick kill strategy really shines. And that is everything you need to know about the Necrodancer 1 boss fight. Hopefully this video will help you in defeating this boss fight more easily. If there's still a strategy that you're aware of but has not been covered in this guide yet, feel free to leave a comment down below, as not only am I curious to see what this strategy is about, but also it might help out other players who are trying to get better at this particular boss fight. Thank you all for watching and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye bye!